I love it. It's so historical, and everyone's really nice, actually. People have stopped and asked me if I needed help getting somewhere. It's really pretty. I like it a lot.
I actually love Canterbury so far. I kind of wish USC was more like it. I really like how it's just one giant campus, whereas USC is kind of like partial campus mixed in with the town and everything else. But so far, I really liked it. I mean, the town's a lot cleaner than Columbia. Columbia's pretty dirty, unfortunately.
It was fun. It was a little tough at first, just, being far from home, not really knowing what was going on. But my housemates were really nice, and everyone got along, and we just had a lot of fun, so.
Well, first week was fresh as week. It was a lot different than what the freshers week would be back at USC. Because basically they encourage you to go out. Here they encourage you to just go out and drink as much as you possibly can, which I think is awesome because I think that's how college. I just think that's what kids want to do in college, is they want to go get drunk and have memories and all sorts of things. USC, you just all they try to do is they get you to do like these like you know really like not really personal events. It's more like they just toss you in the mix of everything and don't really get you accommodated. Because I've some of my best friends here, people that I met Freshers Week.
Probably the worst thing was getting here right after a 7-hour flight over the Atlantic, just being exhausted, not knowing where to go. I ended up walking all over campus. But that was just the first day. But after that, it got a lot better because I was meeting people and found a map, so that's good. That's helpful. But probably my favorite experience from the first week was just meeting everyone, and everyone that I live with is from different places, all over Europe and America, so yeah, that's probably it.
Okay.
Well, the only real difficulty is sort of since Canada's a very international school, the difficulties with like a lot of people you meet are from different countries, so it can kind of be hard to communicate. Speaking from example, like all of my housemates are American except for Pauline, who's from France. I mean, she's really cool, but she just does not speak English very well. So it's kind of like getting used to the whole language barrier. It's very difficult. I have way too many good memories. I don't even know where to start. Most of them have been going out, like nights out. Like we keep making references to the really cheap cider that we always buy at Frosty Jack. That's probably gonna be my biggest memory when I come back. Because our saying now is when we want to get drunk, we'll say we'll text each other, like we'll text our friends and be like, "Are you trying to get Frosty tonight?" Like it's just like something that we do. So yeah, lots of memories.
I've been to London twice, and I really want to go to Paris. That would be just amazing. That's probably the biggest things. London and Paris, I really want to do. I really want to do well in my classes. The academic expectations here are a lot higher, I think. So I'm really hoping that I can meet them. I want to, do some more exploring, Canterbury and around England and maybe Paris. Hopefully, just meet more people and have fun.
Well, I don't really have too many plans for the semester because since I'm pass/fail, I'm taking school seriously, but not as serious as I would if I was back at USC because I only have like three classes. So plans for the semester, I would say mainly just kind of experiencing like the culture, being in a completely different country surrounded by all forms of nationalities.
Oh gosh, where to start? I would say be open to doing new things. Don't you know, don't get too comfortable with what you're used to. Be willing to try new foods and, you know, talk to people even if you don't know them. And if someone offers you, hey, you want to go here today? Say yes. and take care of yourself. Get enough sleep. And eat well, because you need to keep up your strength.
Do your research. Don't just be like, oh, I want to go study abroad in Italy, or oh, I want to go study abroad in Spain. Like, think about, you know, all sorts of things, like, you know, the currency exchange, because I can tell you right away, like, it's the currency exchange from US dollars to pounds is really, really rough to get used to, and you'll spend money like it's dollars, and then you really, like, look at your bank account and you realize, you know, I spend 20 pounds, that's the equivalent to like $31, so like you're blowing money just like that. So definitely do your research, because if you don't, you could get stuck in a country where, you know, you run out of money, you don't speak the language, you know, you can't associate with anybody, people have no idea what you want, they don't know your culture. So definitely do.